Shalom, friends. This is your brother and friend, Chidi Osuchukwu, bringing you the gospel of the kingdom. In Mark chapter 1 and verse 14, the Bible reads, "And when John the Baptist was put in prison, Yeshua went about Galilee preaching the gospel of the kingdom." In Acts chapter 1, after his resurrection, it says that he showed himself through many infallible proof, 40 days to his disciples and also preaching the gospel of the kingdom. So Yeshua preached the gospel of the kingdom when he was alive, and when he rose from the dead for 40 days, he preached nothing else except the gospel of the kingdom. Today, I want to bring to you something very important that every believer should be interested in, either consciously or unconsciously. A few days ago, I was on radio, and after giving the interview with the host, I received multiple calls with a lot of brothers and sisters concerned about the challenging times that we face with coronavirus, the pandemic, the chaos, and the fear it has struck in the hearts of men, governments, and society all over the world. One of the questions that was prominent is, "Sir, please can you help us understand if this is the end of the world?" To those brothers and to you all listening to me, I have a message for you. You are not alone. You are not the first person that asked this question when people felt that there was calamity or things that were too challenging for them to comprehend. So I take you to the scriptures. The Bible holds all answers to everything. The Bible is very complete, tells us about history, tells us about today, and tells us about the future. So I take you to Matthew chapter 23. In Matthew 23, Yeshua was in Jerusalem for the feast of Passover. In that feast, he was accosted by a lot of religious leaders. In the last verse, he stormed out of the Temple Mount and said, "You people, Jerusalem, and your religious leaders will not see me again until you say, 'Blessed is he who comes in the name of Jehovah.'" While he then crossed from the Temple Mountain to the Mount of Olives, that takes us to chapter 24. Four of his disciples met him in private as he was sitting on a stone or boulder upon Mount Olives, and they said to him, I read to you, Matthew chapter 24 and verse 3. "Now, as he being Yeshua, sat on the Mount of Olives, the disciples came to him privately, saying, 'Tell us, when will these things be?'" That's a question. When will these things be? These things you keep talking about, that the end of the ages will come, that you are going to return. When will these things be? "And what will be the sign of your coming and the end of the age?" So clearly there are three questions there. One, when will these things be? Two, what will be the sign of your coming? And three, what will be the sign of the end of the age? So brothers and sisters, if you've asked this question, if you are under any fear or concern about this period of pandemic and uncertainty in the world, you have not been alone. This question was asked to Yeshua himself, the Master, more than 2,000 years ago. And let us see how he answered it. It is better to let the Bible interpret itself. So verse 4 says, "And Yeshua answered and said to them, 'Take heed that no man deceives you.'" This is a very important way of answering, a very curious one, I must say, because he started by saying, "Take heed." You that is asking this question, you are particularly responsible, one, for the answers I'm going to give you, two, for the sign I'm going to reveal to you, three, for what you do with the information that you get. And he says, "Take heed that no man deceives you," verse 5, "for many will come in my name, saying, 'I am the Messiah.'" Your Bible says, "I am the Christ, I am the Messiah," "and will deceive many." Verse 6, "And you will hear of wars and rumors of wars. See that you are not troubled, for all these are things that must come to pass, but the end is not yet." So let me even answer the question before I carry on reading this part. Coronavirus COVID-19 does not signify the end of this world. It does not signify the end of this age. The reason I say this with absolute certainty is because Yeshua himself, in this particular chapter of Matthew, gave the sign that will be the sign of the end of the age and of his coming. That was a question that his disciples asked him. And they asked him this question in private, and he gave them details of what that sign will be. Because of time, I like to fast forward to verse 15. Verse 15 is the sign of the end of the age. They ask him three questions. One, when will these things be? Two, what is the sign of your coming? Three, what will be the sign of the end of the age? Verse 15 is where he started giving them the sign. Initially, he started with, take heed that no man deceive you. Many will try to deceive you. They may even come in my name. They may preach in my name. They may do miracles and signs and wonders in my name, but they will deceive many. And deception is a very important thing. It's a very subtle thing. You will never know you have been deceived. The only way you will not be deceived is pick up the Bible, read it for yourself, ask the Spirit of Jehovah to explain it to you, and you will understand, and you will be firmly rooted and not to be deceived. So he gave them in verse 15 what that sign is. The sign, therefore, he said, therefore, when you see the abomination of desolation spoken of by Daniel the prophet standing in the holy place. This is it. This is the sign of the end of the age. The sighting and the erection of the abomination of desolation. Yeshua says, when you see, you will see an abomination of desolation. Now let us talk about what is abomination. Abomination is something that Jehovah abhors, something he hates, something he does not want to see. Even in our own culture and language, when we use the word abomination, it is in the strongest possible term to condemn something that is either societally wrong, culturally wrong, or personally disgusting to us. So abomination is explained. Now, desolation. Desolation, another word for desolation is desecration. So this is an abomination that desecrates something. That's why Yeshua says this abomination will be standing in the holy place. And where is the holy place? The holy place in Jerusalem. He says, Prophet Daniel said, when you see the abomination standing in the holy place, then let those who are in Judea flee to the mountain. So this is a sign. When you see it, it is time to run. So COVID-19 is not time to run. We will overcome COVID-19. This is rumors of war. This is pestilence. This is challenges affecting the whole world, but does not signify the sign of the end of this world. Neither does it signify the sign of the coming of Yeshua, the Master himself. What will signify the sign is the abomination of desolation. Yeshua gave the sign of his coming as one sign and one sign alone, just like he gave the sign of what makes him the authentic Messiah. He gave that sign of his authenticity as the Messiah to the Pharisees in Matthew chapter 12 and verse 38 to 40, where he says he will be in the belly of the earth, just like Jonah was in the belly of the fish for 3 days and three nights. Answering the question which the Fantastic Four apostles asked him in Matthew 24, he says in verse 15, the sign of the end of the age and his coming is what he called the abomination of desolation. He also gave us further information. He said this abomination of desolation was first spoken of by Prophet Daniel. You may want to go and read Daniel chapter 9 and verse 27, where Daniel talked about an abomination of desolation. But I'd like to take you to 2 Thessalonians chapter 2, where Paul, addressing the believers in Thessalonica, also came up with the same clarification on what is the sign of the end time. So here it says in 2 book to the Thessalonians chapter 2, Paul said, now, brethren, concerning the coming of our Master Yeshua Messiah, and our gathering to him here refers to what many will call rapture, when Yeshua will return for the saints. And our gathering together to him, he says, we ask you not to be soon shaken in mind or troubled either by spirit or by word or by letter, as if from us, as though the day of Messiah had come. So what Paul is saying is, listen, if a spirit, a prophet or prophetess or a letter is written to you telling you that the day Yeshua is coming back is at hand, don't believe it. He says he's going to tell us when we must then believe. He now says, verse 3, let no one deceive you by any means. You remember how Yeshua started answering the question in Matthew 24. He started by saying, let no man deceive you. Be careful. Take heed that no man deceive you. Paul is saying exactly the same thing. When it comes to this all-important topic, when Messiah will return, when the world will come to an end, when the current civilization will end, what is the sign of that? Be sure not to be deceived. Prophets can speak, spirits can speak, letters can come, geos can speak. Focus on what your Bible says. And it says in 2 Thessalonians chapter 2, I keep reading from verse 3, it now says, let no one deceive you by any means, for that day, what day? The day that we will gather unto Yeshua, the day of his return, the day of rapture, the day of the last trumpet, the day that signifies the end of age. That day will not come unless the falling away comes first. Now, I don't have time today to explain to you the error on this part, but it says falling away. Now, let's read a little bit more to understand what falling away actually means. He says the falling away has to come and the man of sin is revealed. So the day the man of sin is revealed, the son of perdition, that man of sin is called son of perdition according to Paul, who opposes and exalts himself above all that is called God or that is worshipped, so that he, this man of sin, sits as God in the temple of God, showing himself that he is God. So let me break this down for you. Yeshua is not returning until someone declares himself as God, sits in the temple of God, says that he is the God of the whole world. Until that happens, that is the sign of his coming. And that's the same sign that Yeshua referred to as the abomination of desolation. Why is it an abomination of desolation? Because someone who is not God sits in the temple of God, says that he is God. So this is the import of today's message. Coronavirus does not signify the end of the world. It is not the sign that the Master himself gave us. That sign is still coming. But we must be careful. What coronavirus shows us today is that the systems of the world are feeble. That Father Jehovah can take out the systems of the world whenever he wants, however he chooses. But for us, it's a warning. For us, it is time for us to have a sober inward reflection. If you are on lockdown, if you are on partial isolation, if you are on social distancing, the most important thing, make the Bible your companion this time. Focus on it, study it, and show yourself a workman approved unto good works to Jehovah. Shalom, until I come next time to continue on this series, stay blessed, stay safe, and may Jehovah protect us all in Yahshua's name. Amen. Christ one day.